Today's class will be given by His Grace Shyami Krishi Prabhuji. He is the disciple of His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. And he is also the initiating guru. So Hare Krishna Prabhuji, you are there on the call?
Yes, I am here. Thank you so
Hare
much
Krishna for giving me.
Hare Krishna, please accept my humble obeisances.
Dandavas Pranam Prabhuji, Dandavas all glory to you.
Prabhuji, I just want to read a little introduction about you.
Okay.
Prabhuji is, has joined ISKCON in 1971. He is a doctor by profession. And he moved to US and then he came in touch with Srila Prabhupada. Prabhuji has done very valuable services. He donated the deities of the Philadelphia temple. And he had hosted the crew of Bhakti Charu Maharaj, around 60 people, when they were doing the very famous tele-serial, Abhay Charan. And since then, Prabhuji has rendered very, very valuable services to the devotee community. And he was a temple president of Tovaco for about 15 years, from 1996 to 2010. And Prabhuji used all his life savings to do a project called Little Temples, where he has a ready-made temple done, and that can be used in the villages as a place of where everybody can get together. The structure has a place for deities to keep the Srimad Bhagavatam books, and everything that's necessary to start a center. And this is only very less of what I know of Prabhuji. Now he is also initiating guru in ISKCON. He's very, very widely well-read, and Prabhuji gives us his valuable association continuously through the conference calls. We offer our humble obeisances unto yourself, Prabhuji. Thank you so much for giving us this opportunity of being able to hear you. And please continue the call, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Namavam Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasvati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyatya Dishtarine Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaurav Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we'll be reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 32, Text Number 34, 35 and 36. They are together in Srimad Bhagavatam. So, Kriyaya Kratubhir Danais Tapa Swadhyaya Marshanaihi Atmendriya Jayenapi Sanyasena Cha Karmanam Yogena Vividhangena Bhakti Yogena Chevahi Dharmeno bhayachinnena yah pravarti nivrati man atma tattvava bodhena vairagena dhradena cha iyate bhagavanebhi saguno nirguna swadrak. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki jai. And the purport is long, it's a 3 verses and it's over 2 pages. So as we go, we will discuss what exactly it means by performing fruitive activities and sacrifices. So fruitive activities, that we work for the fruits, means any karma we do, there is certain reaction and we work always for certain fruits. So fruitive activity is looking for the fruits of our work or our karma. And sacrifices, that by distributing charity, by performing austerities, by studying various literatures, by conducting philosophical research, by controlling the mind, by subduing the senses, by accepting the renounced order of life, and by performing the prescribed duties of one's social order, by performing the different divisions of yoga practice, by performing devotional service, and by exhibiting the process of devotional service containing the symptoms of both attachment and detachment, by understanding the signs of self-realization, and by developing a strong sense of detachment. One who is expert in understanding the different processes of self-realization realizes the supreme personality of Godhead, as he is represented in the material world as well as in transcendence. That means that whatever activity we may do to please Krishna, who is represented here in the material world when he comes, and whatever we see the expansion of Krishna, and also in transcendence means in the spiritual world, and he has so many expansion, and he comes to the material world with so many expansion in the material world, just like Narayan or Narasimhadeva, Lord Ram or Varaha or Matsya avatar or Kurma avatar, and so many avatars. So that is all in the, they come, so that is, they are in the material world, also he is represented in the spiritual world, and he is all the activity, but Krishna is Advaita Jnana Tattva, means he is only one, and he has his so many energies. So there is a material energy, there is a spiritual energy, so Swarup Shakti, there is a Tatastha Shakti, like the Jiva Shakti, and there is also the external energy of the Lord, that is this Jagat or this material world, is his external energy. So all this, but different people have different tendencies, but ultimately they want to obtain him. Means everybody is looking for some kind of happiness in life, but happiness is of the soul, and so if we are looking for happiness, and that happiness comes from Krishna because he is the source. So everybody ultimately is looking for Krishna, but they approach to him by different method. Some method are quicker, some method are not as quick, but there is a direct method that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught, and through the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, we also understand that process is bhakti, but in other processes they also look for bhakti, because bhakti can only give some benediction. Bhakti means it pleases Krishna, and Krishna is the source of everything, so he could give the result of jnana or karma or yoga according to our different desires. So we'll discuss upon all these things, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is described in depth in Sanatan Siksha in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita in the Madhya Leela 22 chapter of the Madhya Leela. So it describes there. So we will read the purport. As it is stated in previous verse, one has to follow the principles of the scriptures. There are different prescribed duties for persons in the different social and spiritual orders. Social orders are like your brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha, sannyas, and there are spiritual orders, four spiritual orders are also there. So there are different prescribed duties for persons in the different social and spiritual orders. Here it is stated that performance of fruitive activities and sacrifices and distribution of charity are activities meant for persons who are in the householder order of society. So if somebody is a grahastha, then they give charity and they perform sacrifices, that is yagya, etc. They may also do some fruitive activities. So there are four orders of the social system: brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha, and sannyas. For the grahasthas or householders, performance of sacrifices, distribution of charity, and action according to prescribed duties are especially recommended. Similarly, austerity, study of Vedic literature and philosophical research are meant for the vanaprasthas or retired persons. Study of the Vedic literature from the bona fide spiritual master is meant for the brahmachari or a student. Atmendriya Jaya, control of the mind and taming of the senses, is meant for persons in the renounced order of life. All these different activities are prescribed for different persons so that they may be elevated to the platform of self-realization and from there to Krishna consciousness, devotional service. And so self-realization means we understand that we are part and parcel of Krishna, and our duty as a part, our duty is to serve the whole. So we come to Krishna consciousness by realizing ourselves that we are part of Krishna, and then we engage in devotional service to know him more. So that we know him more by our Sambandha Gyan, then the process is there, that is called Abhideya, and so that is called Sadhana. And Sadhya is our Prayojan Tattva, our Prayojan is to develop our love of Godhead. Because we are part, so naturally we have to love the whole and serve Him, that is by devotional service. So the word bhakti yogena chevahi means that whatever is to be performed is described in the verse 34, whether yoga or sacrifice or fruitive activity or a study of the Vedic literature or philosophical research or acceptance of the renounced order of life is to be executed in bhakti yoga. The words chevahi, according to Sanskrit grammar, indicate that one must perform all these activities mixed with devotional service. Otherwise, such activities will not produce any fruits. Means without devotional service, we cannot obtain anything by other methods. Other methods like karma yoga or karma, jnana, dhyan, ashtanga yoga. So they all cannot give its results, because result giver is Krishna and he is only pleased by bhakti. Bhakti amam abhijanati yaman yas chasmi tatvata. Only by bhakti we can understand Krishna, and Krishna will bestow his blessings, whether swargalok or the result of karma yoga or karma, that they want to obtain higher planetary system, higher test in swargalok, janlok, taplok, maharlok. So that also is provided by Krishna, because he is the one who gives all the results of our activity according to our desire and according to our method of worship or what we do. So all these material amenities that come also from Krishna. He is the source of everything. So any prescribed activity must be performed for the sake of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 9:27, Yat Karoshi Yadashnashi Yajyoshi Dadasiyat Yat Tapasvasi Konteya Tat Kurushva Madarpanam, that you do it as offering unto me. Whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you give away in charity, whatever austerities you may perform, should be done for Krishna. It is meant for Krishna, and we should do it, and we could take as a remnant, as a prasad. So whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you sacrifice, whatever austerities you undergo and whatever charities you give, the result should be given to the Supreme Lord. The word eva is added, indicating that one must execute activities in such a way that it is offered to Krishna. Unless one adds a devotional service to all activities, he cannot achieve the desired result. But when bhakti yoga is prominent in every activity, then the ultimate goal is sure. One has to approach the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, as it is stated in Bhagavad Gita. After many births, one approaches the Supreme Person, Krishna, and surrenders unto Him, knowing that He is everything. Vasudeva Sarvamiti Sa Mahatma Sudurlabha. Also in Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, Bhoktaram Yajyatapasam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram Shruhadam Sarvabhutanam Yajgyatva Mam Shantim Richati. For anyone who is undergoing rigid austerity, or for anyone performing different kinds of sacrifices, the beneficiary is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is the proprietor of all planets, and He is the friend of every living entity. So, Shruhadam Sarvabhutanam, He is our well-wisher. Yajyatva, that knowing that He is our well-wisher, He is Bhokta, He is the enjoyer, means we should give enjoyment to Krishna. And being His part, we automatically get enjoyment. So, Bhoktaram Yajita Sarva Loka Maheshwaram, He is Maha Ishwar, controller of all the planetary system. Everything is under His full control. And He is our Shruhad. So, knowing these three things, then we could become free from any anxiety. Gyatva Mam Shantim Richati. We all want shanti, peacefulness, that will come from understanding in truth these three things, that who is the source, who is the enjoyer, who is the proprietor, who is controller, and who is our well-wisher. The word dharme no bhya chihinnena means that the bhakti yoga process contains two symptoms, namely attachment for the Supreme Lord and detachment from all material affinities. So both comes together, like if you put on a weighing machine, if you have attachment, then it will go down, then so much less would be our bhakti. And if bhakti is heavy, we are doing bhakti and not attached to the material world. Means acting in the material world is different, but attachment means that has to be there. I'm doing that activity just for gaining some material benefits, and that will give me pleasure. Means it is not correct, because nobody in the material world has ever got happiness that he's looking for. We have been wandering in the material world from time immemorial, but nobody is happy. There is always in want of something or another. Means there is certain deficiency. But once we engage in devotional service, then naturally our all the desires are fulfilled. Whether it is material desires, spiritual desires, any desire can be fulfilled by going to Krishna, as he is the source of our everything. So, in the weighing machine, if the bhakti would be topmost, or that is all in all, then naturally the material attachment would become practically nil. And we should not be, actually our practice, that means by austerity and giving in charity, and ultimate purpose is that we are not attached to the material world. We depend on fully to Krishna, surrender to him, and we have like, so surrender to him completely, and only we are meant for him. Our whole purpose in the material world and human life is meant to serve Krishna and not for our sense gratification. Our senses will automatically be satisfied if we serve Krishna, and if his senses are satisfied, then we will get satisfied. Just like when we eat food, then our hunger is gone, we develop some energy, we could function very well, and we get there is no more hunger, so we don't want any more food. So that craving for food would go away. And similarly, if we have devotional service, then we will realize Krishna, we will be happy also, we will be satisfied completely, and we will get detachment from the material world. There won't be any attachment because we are fully satisfied. So it goes both way. That initially we must try, but then engaging in devotional practices like Navda Bhakti or five processes of topmost processes of items of the devotional activity we do, like there are 64 items, but five are most prominent. So if we engage in all those, then gradually we will be having satisfaction, we will realize ourselves that we are part of Krishna, and there is no need to do any material activity. That does not mean that we just sit. We don't burn the fire or don't do any work, but we work for Krishna. Everything is devoted for Krishna service. Means whatever you, just like we read, whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you give away, it should be done for Krishna. So everything is really meant for Krishna, but out of forgetfulness of Krishna, because of the Maya who covers our intelligence, we think that I should be satisfied. Let me, all these things are meant for me. And that is our mistake. Only we could get that knowledge from a sadhu or one who has realized the self, and are through reading scripture, but reading scripture is not enough. You need certain example, some living person who could teach you and impart you that knowledge, because he is close to the Paramatma. And so by serving a spiritual master, then there is a blessing of a spiritual master and blessing of Krishna also. So he will reveal to you only, just like if there is a ambassador, and ambassador goes away to something treaty, although he does not know, he does not have any power, but still if he is sent by the king to another kingdom, then king will respect him, the other king will respect him, as if the king has come, their talks, their treaty, everything will be accepted, and whose ambassador he is, he also agrees to all the terms and conditions that this person has created. Although by himself is nothing, so same thing, Guru is a representative of Krishna. And Krishna is sitting as Paramatma in Chaiti Guru, but we cannot hear Paramatma's voice. So there is an external manifestation of Chaiti Guru, or in Chaitna, is a spiritual master. So one has to take shelter of him, serve him, make him happy by your service, and then he will give you all the knowledge that you can come to Krishna. Tadvedi pranipatena pariprashtena sevaya upadeshanti te jnanam jnaninas tatvadarshina. Not that he has to be very, very learned in all the scripture, but he should be able to explain to you, and he should be following, and he should be realized. So, two symptoms of advancement. So these two things, detachment from the all the material affinity and attachment for the Supreme Lord, that has to be there by your all the processes. So there are two symptoms of advancement in the process of devotional service, just as there are two processes taking place while eating. A hungry man feels a strength and satisfaction from eating, and at the same time he gradually becomes detached from eating anymore. Similarly, with the execution of devotional service, a real knowledge develops, and one becomes detached from all material activities. In no other activity but devotional service is there such detachment from matter and attachment for the supreme. So this is a very important thing, that what is the test that you are advancing in your devotional service. The test is that you should be detached from the material activity. Your mind should not go for enjoying your senses all the time, but the pleasing the senses of Krishna. So that would be the most important test that you could do in your own life. Not that somebody could, just by seeing you, or some guru could seize you and just says that whether you are advanced or not advanced, but you could test yourself that your attraction for the matter should not be there, and enjoying propensity by the senses, but rather our propensity should be to satisfy Krishna's senses. Rashikesha Rashikena Sevanam Bhaktir Uchyate Sarvopadhi Vinirmuktam Tatparatvena Nirmalam. Sarvopadhi, upadhi means that I am black, white, engineer, Indian, or I have this and this body, I am human being. So all these upadhi we have to give away. Sarvopadhi Vinirmuktam, we should be free from this. Tatparatvena Nirmalam, that our heart should be free from this designation. And Paratattva is Krishna. Rashikesha means the master of the senses, and we have senses, so we should serve by our senses to the master of the senses. Rashikesha, Rashikena means by our senses. Sevanam, we should serve him. Bhaktir Uchyate, that is Bhakti. That is from Narad, Narad Bhakti Sutra. In no other activity but devotional service is there such detachment from matter and attachment for the Supreme. There are 9 different processes to increase this attachment to the Supreme Lord. Hearing, chanting, remembering, worshipping, serving the Lord, making friendship, praying, offering everything, and serving the lotus feet of the Lord. The processes for increasing detachment from material affinity are explained in verse 36. So that verse 36, that's what we have been reading. Atma tattvava bodhena vairagyena dhradena cha iyate bhagwan evihi saguno nirguna swadrak. One can achieve elevation to the higher planetary systems like the heavenly kingdom by executing one's prescribed duties and by performing sacrifices. When one is transcendental to such desires, because of the accepting the renounced order of life, he can understand the Brahman feature of the Supreme. And when one is able to see his real constitutional position, he sees all other processes and becomes situated in a stage of pure devotional service. At that time, he can understand the Supreme Personality of God and Bhagavan. So Krishna is seen in 3 features, that is Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Shabdate. Brahman, that is an effulgence, Abha, that you are looking very far. Paramatmeti, one who is localized aspect with along with the soul or Atma. And Bhagwan, who lives in the spiritual kingdom and comes to the material world in so many ways. And we could see all these 3 by taking to devotional service, or we can understand. But our attachment should be for Bhagwan Swayam, because there would be incomplete realization by knowing Brahma, Brahman, Brahma Jyoti, and knowing Paramatma. So understanding of the Supreme Person is called Atma Tattva, Abodhena, which means understanding of one's real constitutional position, that I am part of Krishna. If one actually understands one's constitutional position as an eternal servitor of the Supreme Lord, he becomes detached from the service of the material world. Everyone engages in some sort of service. So service is in everybody, but Jivira Swarup Hoy, Krishna or Nitya Das. Das means he must serve. Even in any another process, you may say that, oh, I have a Sakya Bhav, or I have Vatsalya Bhav, or Madhurya Bhav, but in that also service is automatically a part in all of this. So we are engaging in some kind of service, but that service is meant for Krishna, not for the material world. So if one does not know one's constitutional position, one engages in the service of the personal gross body or his family or society or country. That is extended with thinking that, yes, I am part of this country, so let me serve a country, or let me serve my community, or let me serve my town or home or family, my wife, my children. But that is a narrow vision. By constitutionally, we are meant to serve Krishna. But somehow we have forgotten, so we will know how we forgot, what happened, and how we could bring it back. So that would be the topic of discussion. But as soon as one is able to see his constitutional position, the word swadrak means that one who is able to see, he becomes detached from such material service and engages himself in devotional service. As long as one is in the modes of material nature, that is tamogun, rajogun, satogun, and is performing the duties prescribed in the scriptures, he can be elevated to the higher planetary system, where the predominating deities are material representations of the supreme personality of Godhead, like the sun god, the moon god, the air god, Brahma, Lord Shiva. They are all representative of the Supreme Lord. They are all the post that is given to them are appointed by the Supreme Lord to manage the material universes, to manage the material affairs. Like Varuna is for the water department, or rain department is like Indra, by which all the crops go and we eat, or sun and moon. They are also providing us the light and so all these, so many demigods, 3.33 koti demigods, but they are all representative of the Supreme Lord, are appointed by the Lord as the post. All the different demigods are material representations of the Supreme Lord. By material activities, one can approach only such demigods, as is stated in Bhagavad Gita. Yanti deva vratan devan, that if you want to go to so many demigods, then by worshipping them you go to that place, but you don't go to the supreme abode of the Supreme Lord Krishna. So that is only if you worship demigods, you worship to demigods. If you worship ghost, you go to the planet of the ghost. If you worship your forefathers, then you go to forefathers planet, where forefathers live. So those who are attached to the demigods and who perform the prescribed duties can approach the abodes of the demigods. In this way, one can go to the planets of Pitas or forefathers. Similarly, one who fully understands the real position of his life and adopts a devotional service and realizes the supreme personality of Godhead, then he go to Krishna's abode. So all the processes that are mentioned, there are so many processes that are mentioned that usually people perform, but that is, it's the aim of any process has to be Krishna. Aim of running, like say earning so much, or raising family. So earning, you earn for Krishna. Build temples in different modes, or it should be more for glorification of Krishna. You may say, how I will eat? Then think that family belongs to Krishna. I belong to Krishna. I have to live, I have a body, it requires food, but food should be sanctified. First, let Krishna enjoy, and I take his remnants. In that feeling, everything should be Krishnaized and should be meant for Krishna. If we could do that and act in that way, raising family, children, they are part of Krishna. They were given in charge of you, so you take care of them, thinking that they are part of Krishna, not that they are my extension, my blood, it is me who has come in this form of the child. In that way, you will get attached to that. Although it is all temporary, everything in the material world is temporary, so we should not make it a permanent business to just take care of this material world and its extension, but should go to a permanent thing. So there is Nitya Karma and Naimittik Karma. Nitya Karma, that is eternal for the soul, whatever like 64 items of devotional service you do here, and in the spiritual world you do the same thing. But Jnana and Karma, and they are not Nitya Karma. That is just temporary, it's the results, and then you don't engage in devotional service. But Bhakti is eternal. You do Bhakti here, like either Navada Bhakti or these five items that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu out of 64, that is the topmost, but that continues in the spiritual kingdom. Bhakti brings more bhakti, and you engage in devotional service again in the spiritual kingdom. But in another processes, if you obtain the result, then the thing is given up. It is not continued. Like if you do a sacrifice to get something, you do Ashwamedh Yagya, Putreshti Yagya, and when your children are born, then that process is given up. It, you don't continue. But bhakti is continued. So, as I said, that we will read from some Sanatan Siksha that is given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he was in Banaras, Kashi. At the same time, he liberated Prakashananda Saraswati also. So, one day, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Devam, Tam Karunarnavam, Kalau Api Ati Gudeya Bhaktir Yena Prakashita. That, although it is a very good tattva, very confidential part, but in Kali Kal, in this age, that he has, out of his mercy, that he has delivered his prakash, means we could all see. So he is a very, very merciful Karunarnavam, then I worship to that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So bhakti, like it is like when Krishna says that I am giving you sarva guhyatamam guhya. Shrunume Vachanam Tav, that in Bhagavad Gita, in 64 verse, that I will give you again, after giving the whole Bhagavad Gita, then he says that I will give you the sum and substance of all this again. And because his eyes were filled with so much tears for his friend Arjun, and he wanted to reveal and he wanted to repeat the whole Bhagavad Gita again, but he says that I am telling you in a nutshell, and if you still could not understand, then you could ask me. But then Arjun says that I am completely satisfied what you have told, and now Karishye Vachanam Tava, that I will act according to your desire. So bhakti tattva, it is good. You may say it is written, anybody can read, but anybody can read, that is true, but they would not understand the purport or what is the tattva behind that, and that has to be imparted by the spiritual master. That tattva, although it is open, you may say it is open secret. Why it is a secret? Why it is guhya? Guhya means very, very confidential, but unless it is you engage in devotional service, it won't dawn to you. It will just, like from a leaf, the drop does not touch on the lotus leaf. It just falls down. So all that knowledge will fall down. It would not come to you, and people who read by themselves, say Bhagavad Gita or even Srimad Bhagavatam, in all the verses from back to forward and forward to backward, even if they could need, they don't become a devotee. Like people study in the universities Bhagavatam or Bhagavad Gita, although it may be somewhat beneficial, it will remove some covering, but unless you surrender and serve the spiritual master, you cannot understand that. And that's why it is guhya or gopniya. So it is not really to be, everybody cannot know that, but Param Karun Mahaprabhu, he even gave for the benefit of everybody. He put it in such a way that everybody can understand and come go back to Krishna. So far, this Kalihat Jeev, he knew that people cannot surrender. He says that Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Vraja, that is surrender. But how to surrender, and it is not that easy. Then he just gave it whomever he touched, whomever heard from his mouth, like many jivas. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was chanting, he was going in Jharikhand, and so many animals were there. They forgot all their animosity and embracing each other, and they were chanting verbally like Hare Krishna mantra, and tears were coming, rolling, and they were dancing. So that is the effect of pure chanting. Prabhupada also gave this chanting very purely to us without any qualification. That is his mercy. That he gave it to us, and so purity is the force. He was so pure that it dawned in our heart and it wintered into our heart. Srila Prabhupada was in Russia for hardly 3 days, but just he taught only one person, but now it is thousands of devotees are there, and that is the potency of the Srila Prabhupada. So the same thing that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he did not see any qualification. Whoever just came to ask for it. So the qualification is laulyam api mulyam, that if you are so much lolupar, so much desire of obtaining, then he distributed that love of Godhead, which is even difficult to obtain by even Brahma. So Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya, Jaya Nityananda, Jaya Advaita Chandra, Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. So all these things we can understand by Sambandha, Avideya and Prayojan. So little bit description about Sambandha Tattva and who is that Sambandha Tattva, who is our. So Sambandha Tattva is that is the only process that is the topic that if we could understand. That Gyan Marga Karma Adi, that has already been given, but ultimately they all also want to know about Krishna. He is the Brahma, Paramatma, that is all part of Krishna. That by Gyan Marga one was to merge into the Brahma Jyoti, so and then have Sayujya Mukti, so that is also Krishna's part. The Paramatma is also a localized aspect that comes from Krishna, and they want to, these yogis who engage in worship of Paramatma or who puts their attention on Paramatma, their aim is to get so many siddhis from Paramatma. Or if you want to have this bhogatma lok, bhogatma means this material world, that there are so many bhog, so much enjoyment, that also comes from, means from, by your karma, by your activity or fruitive activity, you want to enjoy, but that also comes from Krishna. So ultimately it is only one that you have to please Krishna. Means Krishna is Advaita Jnana Tattva, that he is Advaita, he is only one, and all his energies, we are his energies in one way or another. So ultimately Shastra that talks about Krishna, because others like Brahma and Paramatma, they are his ansh and kala. And so many other incarnations, that is also either his prakash or his vilas. So they are not independent. So this material world, that is also a transformation of his energy. So they are not independent. So our Sambandha Gyan, has to be Krishna, because we are related to Krishna. Whether directly or indirectly, we are part of Krishna. So Krishna, so many vibhutis, energies, ansha, kala, that all comes from. So our pratipadya subject, our subject of knowing is Krishna. Our sambandha is from Krishna. So he is the cause of everything. Sarva karana karanam. There is nothing else other than that. So sambandha, samabandha, ana. Sambandha means, bandha means that, and bandha means we are bound up. So we are bound to Krishna. We cannot be separated from Krishna. We are bound, but we don't realize that. So to understand that our relation with Krishna, that we are part of Krishna, our body is meant for Krishna, our body is nourished by Krishna, our everything what we do is Krishna, and if you could make that understand and make that realize that it is all Krishna. So this, our binding or sambandha is continued from anadikal, and it will continue until we continued even in the spiritual world also, that sambandha would be there, that I am his servant, I am meant to serve him. So whether in the material world we are serving, his own, we are serving, you may say, the material world, but that is also part of Krishna. So indirectly, that is avidhi purvak. That service is not a direct service, but whatever we are doing, it is serving Krishna, because we want to obtain ananda, but it is serving some energy of Krishna, external energy, and that she makes us dance in the material world, remain in the material world. Like if you give a bribe to the superintendent of the jail, then superintendent would give some more facility. But the superintendent would like to keep you in the jail for as long as you are giving the bribe. It would not release you. The same thing, if we serve the material world, so many jivas are serving maya, then the result would be that you will remain in the material world. You cannot get. We have to develop our diet, because we are children of Krishna. So we have a direct relation with Krishna. So unless we come to the direct path and indirectly we serve the Maiman or the material world, then we will remain in the material world, because that's what we want. So Krishna gives you. Just see that whether you could be happy by having that kind of relationship. Means we have, you may say that I have my relation with my wife, son, father, mother, brother, sister, or with so much my wealth, I have this sambandh. Why not that my sambandh is with that? But we do not have a samyak bandha. Sambandha means the bandhan or sambandha which is all around. Because these things are, our relation is not all the time. With Krishna, our relationship in the material world, in the spiritual world, you cannot give up the relation with Krishna. Like when we die, then Paramatma goes with us. And even to the hellish planets, if we are a pig, he is also there with us as a pig, to give us the direction, give us the, that we can obtain our desired result. But and when we go to the spiritual kingdom, then Krishna is also there. In Vaikuntha Loka, then there is so many Narayan forms of the Lord. So this material sambandha is temporary, just until death at the most. And even before the death, all these things may, like wife may die, child may die, or parents may die. So that sambandha is temporary, but our real sambandha is with Krishna. So sambandha tattva is Krishna. And that is because it is just a temporary that we have. But nitya sambandha, I was trying to explain to you about nitya karma and namitya karma. Nitya karma is eternally that we do. That is the process of navada bhakti and anything to please Krishna. Our chanting is also nitya karma, because that is there in the spiritual world. Chanting is we are asking Krishna to please engage us directly in his service. And namitya karma, which is it changes according to whether we are Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, human being. So in every life there is a brahmachari's namitya karma is different, and he has to go and beg for the spiritual master. Grahastha or vanaprastha, then his namitya karma changes. Nitya karma, nitya means eternal, that activity which is performed eternally. So bhakti is that process which is performed eternally. So that is our nitya karma. Anything that relates to bhakti is our nitya karma. Namitya karma, like we take a bath to clean ourselves, or we brush our teeth, or go to bathroom for just to evacuate, and so all these things are namitya karma. It's not that it is, although you may be doing it every day in the human life, but that is not a nitya karma. Nitya karma is related to atma, which is nitya, and namitya karma is related to the material body. So our relation is with the Lord, that is nitya. We come from Krishna, and so Shakti Shaktiman, Ansha Anshika, that is, there is a relationship. Ansha and Anshi. Anshi is Krishna and we are his Ansha. So it is going on from Anadikal, means there is no beginning, that from what time and it will continue forever. Although we do not have anubhuti of this, or we do not realize that we have relation with Krishna, just like sometime, like we may, just in the material world, a child may forget his father because he has not seen, like he is 1 year old and father goes somewhere, or he is given to the mother and mother is separated from the father and he forgets his father. But that relationship is never lost. It is still there. He would be his biological father all the time. And same thing that for us also, that our relation is with Krishna, but we may forget that. Why we say that I have relation? Because they are in our happiness and distress, like our parents or our wife or children. That's why we tell them Atmiya. But our real Atmiya means for our Atma, that is really Krishna. Because their help, our parents or children, is only until death. But after that, so Krishna is with us in all our happiness and distress, from anadikal, from time immemorial. So he is real our Atmiya. Means who associates with the Atma, that is called Atmiya. When we are in the Matragarbha, we were in the mother's womb, then he was the one who has arranged for our food inside the womb. When we are born, then the giving the milk in the mother is also, that is because of Krishna. And when we forget him and try to engage in all the bhoga of the material world, all the enjoyment of the material world, then who arranged for all this material world? We cannot produce even a grain of rice. So everything is arranged for our building the house. Then there are whatever concrete, cement, iron, that is also Krishna. It is he arranged all these things. Then afterwards, gives us the soft lap after our death. So it is all that he gives us all this. So to take us from after the karma fall is all finished by our devotional service, then he is the one who takes us to his eternal kingdom, and he arranges for everything if we desire that, if we do it. So our real atmiya, real sambandha is with Krishna and not with anybody else. We make our that we have a relation, but really our relationship is only with Krishna. You may say, what about all this material world? Let's just like you go in a plane or for temporary, you develop relationship, you go and yes, you talk to them, you respect them, you teach them, you laugh, joke, everything. So it is all temporary, like so many stars come in a flood together and they separate forever. So many sand particles come together in the waves of the ocean and then they are separated. So same thing our relation. So we could keep a relation, but it is very temporary. Our eternal relation is with Krishna, and that is the sambandha tattva. Then abhideya tattva, see, there is sadhya and sadhan. So sadhya means that we all are looking for Krishna because he is the source of bliss. That is the prayojan. Prema pumartha mahan, loving. So there is love that we want, love of the soul. Love for the soul is with Krishna. It cannot be satiated then other than this devotional service. So avideya tattva is also that avideya means the process, or sadhya and sadhan. Sadhan or sadhana is one and the same thing, or avideya. That is the process to develop love of Godhead. That is the prema. So we have to know what is the process, how we could obtain that process. Avidhaya, that we understand that we have relationship with Krishna. When we understand that, then whatever the topics are, whatever subject that make us that sambandha with Krishna, whatever process it takes, that we know Krishna and we serve him because we are his eternal servant. So by knowing Krishna, then everything is automatically fulfilled. Means material desires, spiritual desires, everything is fulfilled. So avideya, Abhimukhya, or Abhidha is another word, like dharana karna means to dharana. You may say that we are engaged, or he is holding us, he is putting us together. So by the way, process by which we turn our face towards the Krishna. See, we have our material world that we are is because of the Sri Krishna Bahirmukh. We have turned our face opposite to Krishna. We are not facing towards Krishna. So avideya is the process that brings us, that turns us around towards Krishna. So any process that removes our Bahirmukhta. Bahirmukhta means our face or our activity is for the material world. We think that is all in all, but that is not all in all. That is temporary, that changes, that dwindles and finishes. All the universes, everything is destroyable. It destroys. They have its a certain time period. So we have to turn towards eternal, and that is Krishna. We have to turn. So any process that makes us turn or Bhagavat Unmukta Prapta Ho, that is the devotional service, or that is the process. So that is Abhideya. So bhakti is the abhideya tattva. That if you understand bhakti ka abhideya tattva. Krishna bhakti abhideya sarva shastre kaya ateva munigan kariyache nishya. That muni, that they are sitting together and they decided that is the only this bhakti. And bhakti is the abhideya. Abhideya means the kartavya also, the duty also, you may say. Sarva shastre kaya, shruti, smriti, purana, adi, they are saying that is the bhakti, that you could remove your bahirmukta are turning away from Krishna. And so there are four questions that Sanatana Goswami asked. Whose bhakti we should do? व्हाट इज भक्ति, भक्ति किसको कहते हैं, भक्ति किसकी करनी चाहिए, द थर्ड क्वेश्चन इज हु शुड डू भक्ति, भक्ति कौन करे, एंड कर्म योग ज्ञान रादर देन डूइंग दिस व्हाई वी शुड डू भक्ति, दैट इज ऑल्सो डन फॉर फॉर कृष्णा. सो एंड महाप्रभु इज गिविंग दिस एंसर्स, एंड वंस वी टॉक अबाउट दिस थिंग्स देन आई मीन इट्स ए लार्ज टॉपिक, व्हाई कृष्ण इज अद्वैत ज्ञान तत्व एंड वॉट इज ऑल दिस जीव तत्व एंड नित्य मुक्त एंड नित्य बद्ध जीव, सो इट्स ए लॉन्ग टॉपिक. सो बट लेट अस अबाउट एंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन, दैट भक्ति किसकी करनी चाहिए, हुज भक्ति वी शुड डू. लाइक इफ वी गिव वाटर यथा तरोर मूला निशेषचयनेन तृप्यन्ति तत् स्कन्दभुजोपशाखा प्राणोपहारांच यथेन्द्रियाणां तथैव सर्वार्हणम् अच्युतेज्या, दैट एज वी वाटर द रूट देन होल द ट्री बिकम ग्रीन, इट इज सेटिस्फाइड ऑल द फ्रूट्स एंड लीव्स एंड एवरीबडी सेटिस्फाइड. सो सेम थिंग बाय वर्शिपिंग कृष्णा देन ऑटोमेटिकली वी आर लाइक वाटरिंग द रूट. Bhakti is like watering the root, then you don't have to water individually. Means everybody becomes, the whole universe, everybody becomes happy by doing that process. If you chant loudly, then all the living beings who are there, the place, everything gets purified. So by doing, engaging in different, so it is the best process to serve the humanity is engaging in devotional service and make others also bring to Krishna's lotus feet. So bhakti, whose bhakti we should do? Krishna's, because he is the sarva karana karanam, he is the cause of everything. And what is bhakti? Bhakti kisko kehte hain? So bhakti, bhaj means seva, so we it is engaged and it is for his priti, not our vasana, our kaam. So if we serve Krishna, then naturally it is to for his pleasure, then that is bhakti. Anyabhilashita shunyam jnana karmadi anavratam अनुकूलेन कृष्णानु सेवनं भक्तिर उत्तमा और सवै पुंसां परो धर्मो यतो भक्तिर अधोक्षजे अहेतुकी अप्रतियता ययात्मा सुप्रसिद्धति. सो सेव्य का प्रीति विधान, दैट वी शुड मेक सेव्य एंड सेवक, सो दैट भाव, दैट टू सेपरेट हैज ऑलवेज हैज टू बी देयर, दैट ही इज द सेव्य, ही इज टू बी सर्व्ड एंड वी आर हिज सेवक. एनी प्रोसेस दैट kills this sevya sevak bhav, like in gyan yog when you merge into brahma jyoti, then who is sevak and who is sevya, that is gone. So in many things that when we do, there is no, you worship Krishna until you obtain your boons, and when you get it, you throw Krishna. The mayavadis also do the same thing, that we need the dithis until we realize that I am the same person, and so you take his position and throw the dithi worship, that is not done. So those are misunderstanding, or that is not correct. So we have to understand from Srimad Bhagavatam and from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, that we understand that. So any process like bhakti is that by which Krishna is satisfied, and we should do any activity that we do for Krishna, for his satisfaction, then that is bhakti. So our mind should not go towards that, how I become happy. That side the mind should not go. So that is, then third question was bhakti kon kare. Sarvam khalu, if everybody is sarvam khalu idam brahma, Mahavadi say that if everything is brahma, then who does whose bhakti? Everything is brahma, everything is part of Krishna, but if somebody understand that everything is Krishna, so there is no difference in anybody, but it's not. We are a jiva, we have a energy. Energy and energetic are eternally separate. It's not that energetic which gives the energy. We are separate, and then the energy has to serve the Lord. So that is what, it is one at the same time, it is separate also. Energy is one because it comes from Krishna. But energy is different because it is depends on Krishna. So that is called achintya, bheda and abhed. Both are necessary. There is a bhed and there is abhed also. So in the Leela there is a bhed. Achintya, bheda, abhed. So there are two kinds of living being, Nitya Mukta and Nitya Baddha. So the Jiva are of two kinds. Nitya Mukta are eternally they live, they are parshad of the Supreme Lord and they live in the spiritual kingdom. And Nitya Mukta are in the material world, and we have forgotten Krishna. We have become Bahirmukh, the Nitya Baddha Jiva, and that's why we are suffering so many like Adi Devik, Adi Bhautik, Adi Atmik, suffering of the threefold material miseries. And if we turn towards the Krishna, that is the Abhideya Sadhan. And so it should be done for Krishna. And so why we should do only bhakti? Why not yoga and jnana and karma yoga? Yagya and so many other things. So only bhakti can bring turn our face towards Krishna. So Maya is also Bhagavat Shakti, and she would not let us go away. Just like I was said, that superintendent of the jail, Maya is also superintendent of this material world, which is like a jail, prison house, and we have been given freedom here to choose either Krishna or attached to the Maya. So if we are attached to the Maya, we remain towards Maya, with Maya. And if we turn our face towards Krishna by bhakti, then naturally we will become free. So we should do, rather than jnana, yoga and karma, we should engage in Krishna's bhakti. We are Krishna's Nityadas, not Maya's Nityadas. So that is our Swarupa Anubandhi, which is our... And even if you do karma, yoga or jnana, as we read, bhakti mukh nirakshak karma yoga jnana, that only without bhakti or Krishna's mercy you cannot get the results of karma yoga and jnana. That's why that rather than going karma yoga and jnana, which is incomplete and we can't elevate to Krishna's place in his spiritual kingdom or loving devotion, so we should engage in devotional service to Krishna rather than karma yoga and jnana. It's almost then hour, so I will, there is a one nice verse that I wanted to, just how we remain in the material world and what we do, and I have, Kama dinam katina katidha palita durni desha, tesham jata maina karuna natrapa nopa shanti, utsrajay ta nat yadupate sampratam labdha buddhi, tva mayata shranabhayam mam niyum shvatma dashe. This is from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Kama Adinam, that because of so many Kam, Krodh, Kam and Adinam means other thing. It really starts with Kam. Kam means Atmendriya Priti Ichha Talebari Kam. If you want to satisfy, that is Kam. And Kam. So, and then Krishnendriya Priti Vancha Tarebali Prem. So, Prem means if you feel desire of Krishna, if you satisfy Krishna's senses, then that is bhakti or so kamera tatvira nija sambhog keval. Kam ka, the purpose of kam is to nija bhog sambhog, that you enjoy. Bhoga means enjoyment. Nija sambhog keval, just to please yourself, your senses. So kama dinam is what happens. Kam means along with that there is krodh, lobh, moh. It all starts with the kam. Just like by their atma buddhi vash or swasukh vasna or deha avesh in the deha, then there is kam. But when it is not satisfied, then there is anger. And if it is satisfied, then you want more. There is more, you want to obtain more. So lobh. So they all start from kam. So kam, yeah, deha avesh, that I am this body. That is our forgetfulness. So, and then with this, then at that time, what happens that we become completely attached, jnana shunya. We just want to get more and more. So that is called moha. Moha means illusion, that will is giving me satisfaction. And then with the moha, or without understanding what we are, we develop mada or madamatata, become like, completely like hunted. Mada, madonmatta. And we cannot tolerate somebody else getting bigger than us. Like if you want to earn money, how he got it, why not me? So that is called matsarya, that we cannot tolerate somebody. So everything starts from kam. And kam means desires to enjoy the self, that is the body. We think that I am the self, but we are not the self. Atma is the, we are atma. This self just goes away. It is not, the body is not, have no permanency, but we are permanent. So that is how, so he is saying, praying, kamadinam katina katida, but even I have been satisfying durnideshe. He is just alluring me in so many ways, he is giving me adesh, and how many that we have, kama means the desires, ichchai. So we have been fulfilling those from time immemorial, but he never got any tesham karuna, but he did not become any merciful to me. Kuch bhi he, usko daya nahi aayi, na trapa. The trapa means he did not even feel lajja that that he is serving me for so long. So let me be at least be ashamed that I did not help him, or I am just asking more, more and more. So trapa means lajja, no prashanti, neither he become did not make me free. He just made me a slave. Who has made me a slave? This kamadi. Utsrajyate ye nath yadupate sampratam labdha buddhi. Say, hey yadupati, hey Krishna, by your mercy, now I become knowledgeable, I understand that. So, leaving that their shelter, sharanam means shelter of the kama, but I am now, I am taking shelter of your abhayapat. Abhay means fearlessness. So please engage me in your devotional service. Aap mujhe apne dasya mein niyukta kare. So that is very nice verse to remember. This is from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 3225. So please remember, and thank you so much. We can unmute and we can discuss. It's a very, very long topic, like so we just talked only little bit about Avedi and Sambandha, and then the Prayojan Tattva is also there. We did not go through, and but all these things, like as we said, that what has been described, that Vishnu, this is also in that Vishnu, like even if you give Tuladan means the gold according to your body weight, or Ashwamegh Yajna, or you go to Tirthistan, Varanasi, Prayag, Gaya, Vedpath, Japa, like chanting, Ugra Tapasya, Yam, Niyam, Adi. But ultimately it is, this all things without bhakti, it cannot bring us to Bhagavad Shri Prapti. We could not obtain the lotus feet of Krishna. So the fastest process, Srila Prabhupada says, it's like a elevator. You just press button and you go to the 100th, 200th floor, or like a Sputnik, you could go to very, very planets which are very, very far away. So bhakti is the real process, and we should take that very seriously if we can understand that and take to that and turn our face to Krishna. Hare Krishna. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. So please unmute for more discussion.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Dandatna. Very,
very interesting, Prabhuji, and very important. Our Bhakti Lata Guru, how to make a spiritual progress. Thank you very much, Prabhuji. And I request all the devotees, if they have any questions and or comments, they can ask.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, can you please explain a little more about Sambandha, Prayojana and Abhidhya?
Like okay. See, Sambandha Gyan, that eternally we have relation with Krishna. We are part of Krishna, and that is only our Sambandha, is only with Krishna. We may say, but that is all given by Krishna. We may relate to our family members, our wealth, our home, but where is ultimately it comes from? Nothing comes by, so it comes from Krishna. It is His energy. So we don't recognize, but we have relation with Krishna. So why not to have a direct relation rather than through family members? So we are attached to so many temporary things. which finishes in due course of time. So our sambandha should be really attachment. Sambandha means you may say our attachment or that is with Krishna. It is eternally. It was there since we are born, even in the mother's womb, and later on, and even we die, our sambandha is with Krishna, not with anything material. So sambandha means we have relation with Krishna that we have to understand by heart. And we have to practice that sambandha. Like say, you have to practice like wife and husband sambandha, son and mother, son and the father sambandha. So there is sambandha, but they are all temporary. That is not our main sambandha. Our means samyak, samyak rupena, all around or from everywhere, that we have, even in the material world we may be related, but we have to recognize that it is really sambandha with Krishna, not temporary sambandha, or not recognizing that. Even if we don't recognize, we do have sambandha, but if we recognize, then we turn our face towards Krishna. We are thinking that material world is providing me. Like Russians, they used to go in a truck and give all the bread loaves, that who is giving you? The communist government is providing you food. Then now you chant Hare Krishna. Do you get any food? So they think, but who has produced the food? Who has brought the wheat and grown the bread? And who has given the heat to make that from the wheat, make the flour and make the bread? So it is all Krishna, but because we take it this temporary thing as if there's some machines are producing something. But machines also come from Krishna. He has given the intelligence, the form, the heat comes from Krishna, the light comes from Krishna, the hair comes from Krishna. So we have our relation with Krishna eternally, but because we have forgotten, and so that has to be brought back by knowing more and more about Krishna. So material world is like Maya, Pishachi, or somewhere it is Sukri Vista, this Pratistha and all these things in the material world. So we have become Das of Kam Krodh, Kam Krodhir Das Haya, Tar Lati Khai, Brahmite Brahmite Yadi Sadhu Vedipai. That by going here and there, that we have been getting kicks by the Maya. But by some mercy, Sadhu Vedipai, wandering here and there, then we may come across some Sadhu Vedya. Just like we act as if we are haunted by a ghost. And once that ghost could be removed by Oja. So our real Oja is Guru or scriptures, and they could remove our ghost because we act abnormally all the time. Nitya Badha Krishna Hati Nitya Bahirmukh Nitya Sansari Bhunje Narkadi Dukh. So Sei Doshe Maya Pisachi Danda Kare Tare Adhyatmika Di Tapatre Jari Tare Mare. That three types of tapatra, that is like a stick by the Maya, and she is beating us, and we don't recognize that we are being beaten by this Maya's danda. And so now we have to get some, you may do any treatment. The ghost would go away by certain mantras, by some kind of Vedya or Oja. And same thing, that our Maya could be removed, that we don't recognize that Krishna is although the relation is there, but we don't recognize that. So we don't care about that. Like say, a Rajkumar is hunted by a ghost, and he shouts, but he is a Rajkumar nonetheless. And so long time the king, the father, tries to cure this ghost thing, but it does not go away. But then some person, the Oja, comes and he removes his ghost. Means he was even kicking his father, and when he was haunted by the ghost and cry and pass his stool anywhere and would not recognize that he is the father. But once his ghost is gone, then he comes his normal condition. He behaves properly. He accepts his father, the king, that he is providing. He respects him. He serves him. So we are also haunted by the ghost in the material world. That ghost is Maya. And unless we become free, so our sambandha, we think that my sambandha is Maya. Because the man who is haunted, he always thinks that it is my relation is with this ghost. So we have forgotten that. So somebody has to come and remind us that you are son of such a rich father. He lives in the spiritual kingdom. You go to him and turn your face towards him and serve him, and he will take you back. He is so kind and merciful. So our Sambandha Gyan means we understand our relationship with Krishna and understand that and act on that way. That is Avideya. And our prayojan is Krishna Prem.
Mm-hmm.
So it's in a short answer, but it's a very big topic about Sambandha Avideya and prayojan tattva. Means how you could do, the process is long, why bhakti yoga? Then you have to go with karma, jnana, yoga and astanga yoga and all this. What is that process, what we realize and whether they are full or not and why we have to do only bhakti yoga. We talked in a little bit short term, but that is, what is the sambandha, avideya in the process or sadhana or sadhan, that is also avideya and the goal is Krishna's lotus feet, serving Him, Krishna Prem. Pumartha, we think that dharma, artha, kam, moksha is our real duty, or that is, but the purushartha means it is that we should be performing that to get our earth or enjoyment. But that is not dharma, artha, kam, moksha, is not our main thing. And out of this dharma, artha, kam, and moksha, the worst thing is moksha. Because desiring moksha means when they talk to merge with Brahma Jyoti, then you can't do anything. You are just hanging in the Siddha Lok or in the atmosphere, Brahma Jyoti, you are hanging. You don't have a place to stay. Then you have to fall down. So people who think that they are now in Brahma Jyoti, they fall down. Because there is no place to stay. Like a bird flying in the sky, he has to come to the earth to take shelter, some tree or some place on the mountain, but he cannot just fly. So these people are imagining that they could cross over a hole, but they have to take a shelter at in either Vaikuntha Loka or Krishna Loka by serving the lotus feet of the Lord.
Thank you Prabhu very much. So in short, Sambandh Gyan is a relationship to Krishna. And avidya is the means or the process, and prayojana is our aim or the, you know,
goal.
Goal.
So, right.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, bro. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, Prabhuji. It was very good answer, you know, and very good example about the post.
Thank you.
We are haunted. Because of the Maya. And we are always, all the time serving Maya instead of serving Krishna.
Right.
Thank you.
So these examples are to make us understand that we understand. Otherwise, and we have to take the material examples that we know and we realize, then it is easily digested. We easily understand.
Yeah. Thank you, Prabhuji. Anybody else has any questions?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Please accept my humble obeisances. So,
Hare Krishna, accept my humble obeisances.
It is mentioned that everything has to be executed. Even jnana yoga, other yoga, everything has to be with bhakti. Somewhere it is mentioned in that purport. So I was wondering, if bhakti is required in all cases, why we have the other systems present, all that we should have had was only bhakti yoga, not any other method. I was wondering why those things were even there.
Mentioned. See, yeah. Everybody has a different mental. Your question is very not only genuine, but very nice. But because bhakti is also very simple, and in the material world to gain something, you have to work very, very hard. So if they understand that bhakti is topmost, it is so much that we could go transfer. So they think that process of just chanting or process of remembering Krishna, his lotus feet, or serving. So those things as compared to jnana, that you have to study so many scriptures, so much like in dhyan yoga also, you go to a jungle and sit on a deer skin and meditate for long time and many, many births. And so they think that how the bhakti could give the topmost result. So they do people, and because different people come and teach different ways, and so they do, but there is no need of doing all these things. It's not, they say that all this, until these are part of bhakti or until they are done to obtain Krishna, this won't give any result. So it's better, that's what we have been taught by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that you just engage in bhakti. That is like you are sitting in a sputnik and going with a fast speed to Krishna's lok. So no need to do any of these things. Just engage in please Krishna. But pleasing Krishna means we should use our senses for satisfaction of the master of the senses. Rishikesha, Rishikena, Sevanam, Bhakti Ruchyate. So bhakti means we have given the senses, we have given the body. So by our body, mind, words, possessions, wealth, then that should be used for Krishna, for his satisfaction. Then that is bhakti. We don't have to do any of this. But people have, they are world so hard, Ugra Karmis, unless they do very hard work like so much tapasya or so much like putting their head down or lying on the thorns or dipping themselves in the water in the cold weather, like it's so cold, and they dip themselves in the water and they see that unless we perform, we can't realize. It's not needed at all. Only bhakti is, for simple-minded, it is simple. That's why it is called like it's a guhya, or it is very secret, or it is not known. Although if you know, then bhakti, you just, what is the difficulty in chanting, eating, dancing for Krishna, and serving with your hands. So it is not a difficult thing, but people have gone through their life with so much difficulty, they want to take some difficult process. But ultimately, this all is study and all these things has to be for Krishna. Otherwise, you can't get any result of any of those processes. Whether you study scriptures, but if you don't adopt in your life bhakti, then what is the use of reading so many scriptures and so much and knowing and understanding? Just that won't work. It has to come to devotion to Krishna. Krishna prem karke hi aap, you could obtain the result of those things. So, and there is no need to do any of those processes. Directly you can take the bhakti path. But some people don't take it directly or cannot take it by their mentality. So let them do those, but ultimately they have to come to bhakti. But it may take many, many lifetimes. And they may fall back again. So we have done many times all these other processes, but we have missed our chance of taking to bhakti. Like somebody is in a fort or kila where there are 8.4 million doors, and but all the doors are closed. You can't get out. It is all locked from outside. But only one door is open. That is the human life. And if you have obtained a disease called itching, so you try to enjoy senses at that time, then you will pass that that door, and again you have to go through 8.4 million doors, round and round. So we have been going round and round from time immemorial, but somebody suggests you, some sadhu vaidya comes, that this is the door, don't sleep, wake up and get out from this door, because there is so much fire inside the fort and so much smoke. And so then take to siksha and then get out from the door if it is open. So that open door is the human life. So we should take advantage of that fully and get out of this rather than going to processes which cannot give us the topmost result. So just do bhakti. It's a very good question that you ask, but those things
are described.
Yes.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, if I understood correctly, Anil Prabhu asked why there are other methods described if bhakti is the best, then why not just have bhakti?
Why not just bhakti? Methods? Yeah, but yes. Some people...
So that is,
No, I understand your question. So if you don't have to take any another... This are there for them who cannot take, like say there is like a ladder. Like you may take to, but it's not, you could go to the top without going through the ladder, without going through the steps, you could go to the topmost just by taking a process of bhakti, which will take you to the all the way to the top process. So those processes are there who cannot take to bhakti directly, who don't want to surrender. Why I should? I am right. Free. So for them, there are other processes. You take at least some. So there is a gradual elevation. From tamogun to rajogun, rajogun to sattvagun, sattvagun to sattva-suddhagun, or from karma to jnana, jnana to yoga process, and then you come to bhakti. But you could take to directly also. It is there for different mentality. Everybody is different. Like my food may be different than yours, but both could be prasad.
Right.
Only, so there are so many things.
So simple, but not everybody can take to it. Yeah.
Right. That's why for those people who cannot take to bhakti directly. That's right.
Right. Thank you. Thank you, Prabhuji, and thank you, Amaradha Prabhu, too, for your comments.
Yeah.
Too.
Okay, thanks.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, all these other things, they are mentioned in Bhagavad Gita also, right?
Right.
Yeah.
What?
So is it like because of that people may get confused, you know? They already so many people are confused, like, you know, they do Dhyana Yoga and Jnana Yoga and like that.
No, see, Prabhupada has, in his commentary, he made practically every verse into a bhakti. Means those are there, Jnana Yoga and Karma Yoga, but independently they cannot give any result. He gave because people are following those paths, but ultimately he comes to bhakti. And that you come to bhakti, that is all in the first six chapters, it is Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga and last six chapters, and Bhakti Yoga is in the middle. But that karma, if it is done for Krishna, it becomes a bhakti yoga. If the knowledge is to acquire or know, understand our sambandha jnana and understand Krishna, then it is not knowledge. That jnana yoga means by your own mental concoction that you come to something, it would be like this, Krishna would be like this, he would like, but you ask and Krishna is saying that you come to me, just surrender unto me, depend on me, just like a cat and kitten. So in that way, he is trying to teach us, but unless these all paths are given, people will take, no, he has given one way, there is some another way, then try that another way. So he has given all this, so that is very, like Arjun wanted to, although Krishna puts his own devotees in such position to come to realize. So we get their example. Just like, unless you give some material example, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not want to give darshan to the king, who was a pawn-selling person, who was Vishayi, and knowing him to, although he was a very pure devotee, but Maharaj Pratap Rudra, and even Nityananda Prabhu and Sarvam Bhattacharya, they asked that please be merciful, he wants to see your lotus feet and serve you, but he would not let him come and give his darshan. But then his Kripa Shakti or mercy or his then when he was lying down in the Rath Yatra, lying down in a garden, and then this Pratap Rudra comes and then he sings a Bhagavad Shlok. And then his Kripa Shakti comes, and as by his Kripa Shakti, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu refused him for many years. He embraces him. So that Krishna's Kripa Shakti, so that is also, this bhakti is Kripa Shakti of the Krishna, his mercy, his Ladini Shakti, which is he implants in us. But we have to look for it. We have to want to have that. Because Krishna does not want to force us. Sometimes devotee could force, but Krishna does not want to force us. By forcing, there is no law. It's like a robot. You force him to do certain by putting some certain buttons. Like sometime I used to say that the servant and a wife, the difference is that servant, it is by force you ask them her to work. But a wife, out of love, she does service. So out of love, if you serve Krishna, that is bhakti.
Yeah.
Means by full understanding inside, we do that. Yes, He is the one who is providing me. He is my Lord and Master. He is the Pati, Bharta, everything. He is the one who is feeding me. If we think that he is Samam Bonabhav, everything comes from him, then we will surrender to him. We will serve him. But some people cannot come to that stage. Then for them, for gradual elevation, there are other processes. And some don't accept that there is anything. Just pleasing senses like so many demons and so many who don't accept anything. That there is all this material world came by itself, so there is no cause of, there is no sarva karana karanam, there is no cause of behind that. It's just automatic. Then those people, they don't even talk about any process. Whatever pleases them, yato mat tato path, they just do it.
Yeah.
So, most of the people are in that category. Don't accept any kind of process. Or anything that there is some superior cause. When we die, everything is gone. We are born just because of some combination of some chemicals. So we are all the chemicals. By some combination, we became human being. By this Darwin's theory, just we were monkeys in the past life, and now we have become human being. And once we die, everything is all finished.
Yeah. Yes, Prabhuji, we need to. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So, we should.
Hare Krishna, thank you so much, Prabhuji. Very, very wonderful class. And we learn a lot hearing from your classes, Prabhuji. Thank you so much for your association.
Thank you for giving me opportunity in association. I very much appreciate. If there is anything in between, because after 1st of February, I won't be here. I will try to give up from 14th or 15th of February. I will be in my hometown, so I could still communicate after that. So 15 days from 1st to 15th. But if there is any other time that you don't get anybody or your other group, if they want me, I mean, it's unfortunate that there is a splitting of the different groups. But if there is any need, talking about Krishna, everybody should hear about Krishna or should. So, anyway, if there is a some way or so, if others also want, then you let me know.
Yeah. Yes, Prabhuji.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Vancha kalpatarubhyasya kripa sindubhyavacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo nama. Ananda koti vaishnavarinda ki jaya. Srila Prabhupada ki jaya. Gaur bhakta vrinda ki jaya.
Yes.